good about the fact that he's making a change that makes him comfortable with moving forward. We had a good talk yesterday. I resigned. He accepted it. And then we started working together and talking quite a few times about who would be a great pick to come in here and be the chief of staff. And I can't think of anyone better than a four-star general, John Kelly.
That'll interview tonight at 10 on Sean's show. For more on the departure of Reince Priebus and the elevation of John Kelly to White House chief of staff, we're joined by writer, columnist, and let's be honest, savant, Charles Krauthammer. Charles, what does this mean? What's the obvious takeaway from what we're watching today?
Well, the obvious takeaway was that this was a White House in chaos, and it simply couldn't continue. That old saying from the former chairman of the Economic Commission for Richard Nixon was, when something cannot go on, it won't.
Stein's law, yes.
Stein's law, it won't go on, and it had to. You know, Priebus is a good man, the president is right, but he was over his head. He was not a confidant of the president. He didn't have the authority that you needed. People went around him. Now, what the White House needed, and I think, Pete, the reason that you haven't had even Democratic criticism of the appointment, is that we are getting what we needed, which is somebody who will be the gatekeeper, somebody who will restore some kind of order, somebody who will be the authority. And I do think, we talked about this earlier in the night, the test case is going to be, everybody's going to have to go through the chief of staff, we hope. The test case is Scaramucci. If Scaramucci has a direct line, then we are going to have parallel governments. If Scaramucci has to go through Kelly, then we are going to have something that resembles a reasonable chain of command.
Is it even possible that General Kelly would have left a good job and a great reputation accrued over 40 years in public service to take a job where he didn't have authority over the communications director?
I think you're right. I think that would have been a condition. The interesting question is, and I think Scaramucci will have to go through Kelly. The interesting question is, what about the president's daughter and son-in-law? That's a whole different category. You know, we elected a president, but we also elected, knowingly or not, a royal family. And that's a different order of magnitude than just the director of communications. So I suspect they will have their own access. But I think for discipline and the staff, Scaramucci is going to be the test case.
Yeah, a Marine general, if he can't pull that off, it can't be done. There are ideological fault lines in the administration that don't often come to the surface, but they're real and they're obvious to people who work there, between the kind of soft nationalists represented by Steve Bannon and the New York finance people, who are many there. Does Kelly obviously align with either one of those sides?
I don't think so. I think he's the arbiter. He's the guy who's neutral. He's the guy who imposes order. He's the, he's the gatekeeper. He's the bouncer. And that's his job.
You think he'll be able to do it?
I think he will. But in the end, it depends not on him, but on Trump. You know, the success of a chief of staff is 90% whether he has the authority and the confidence of the president, and whether the president will listen to him. I'm rather pessimistic about that, but if anybody can do it, it'll be Kelly.
So I have to ask you a health care question. Is it over for the moment, the push to replace Obamacare with something else?
I think so, and it should be. They ran into a dead end. I'm rather critical of McCain's vote. I don't see why he didn't want to proceed to conference to see whether Republicans could have hammered something out. But this is really a dead end. They're going to have to regroup and do this with Democrats. And I think the key here is going to be semantic. The Democrats want their pound of flesh for the failure, and they're going to extirpate the word repeal. Republicans are going to have to abolish the word repeal. If they talk about repair, and in the end it won't make much difference on the ground in the substance of things, that's where we're headed. We're going to repair Obamacare. And as we see, over 7 years, the country got used to it and didn't want to give it up.
the Improve Obamacare Act next year. Charles, thanks a lot for that, for putting it in perspective.
Sure, my pleasure, yeah.